I stayed on at Woods Hole over the winter to purify the first motor of the kinesin superfamily, which was a new motor protein at the time. We now know that kinesin is not one motor, but it's a large family of related motor proteins. For example, in humans, there are 45 different genes encoding different kinesin motor proteins. And there's so many because they're involved in many different kinds of motor activities, not just axonal transport, which first motivated this study, but a variety of other cargo transport and even activities in cell division, such as the construction of the mitotic spindle and the separation of chromosomes. These motility experiments really are what opened up the field. It first of all opened up the field by allowing us to be able to detect this activity of a motor protein that was critical for the subsequent purification. In many ways, the purification is technical. We had biochemical techniques that were already well established that we could use to go about and purify a protein. So these in vitro motility experiments really provided the foundation of being able to assay and detect the activity of a motor protein that we could then apply to the purification of a kinesin. But it was much more than that. These in vitro motility experiments, you know, kind of gave us this window into this life of what a motor protein is actually doing and how it might be working. It kind of gave us an experimental tool that we just didn't have before to study motility. I mean, before we could just look at cells with a microscope a little bit helplessly, seeing all this motility going on, but not knowing really how to dissect it or how to understand it or how to experimentally manipulate it. It was fascinating, of course, but we really couldn't get at the basic questions of how these machines might actually work. These in vitro motility experiments essentially opened up a whole new frontier of how we can measure motor proteins.